In this video, I'll show you how to do an engine compression test. Doing this will help determine the health of your engine valves and piston rings. I'll do this on a 2009 Honda Civic. However, the procedure is the same for most, if not all, gas engines. The reason why you would do a compression test include engine misfire, a dead cylinder, the vehicle just won't start, or maybe you're buying a used car with a lot of miles on it. I already have my compression gauge set up and I have my spark plugs removed. So let's get started. As you can see, I have my compression tester hooked up so you can see it. I just need to put my hose in the cylinder. There's two different sizes. That's for the smaller plug, which I have, and then that's for a larger plug. I'll go ahead and just put it in there and I'll screw it in. It's also a good idea to remove the fuel pump relay. I didn't do it on this car because I removed the coils and there's no chance of a spark. Now connect the compression gauge to the hose that's in the cylinder. Now crank the engine 5 to 6 revolutions while holding the accelerator pedal all the way to the floor. So we have about 170 on cylinder number one. Let's release and go to the next cylinder. I'm going to crank the engine 4 to 5 revolutions while I hold the throttle pedal all the way down to the ground. This cylinder has about 160 PSI. Let's release the pressure and go to our next cylinder. This cylinder is about 155. I'll release the pressure. Remove the quick disconnect and remove the hose from the spark plug hole. We'll go to the last cylinder. It's all screwed in. Connected. Accelerator pedal held to the ground. Crank it 4 to 5 revolutions. This cylinder is about 170 PSI. Let's go ahead and release the pressure. Remove the disconnect. All right, let's analyze our readings. The car has 155,000 miles on it, and I'm having no issues. As a general rule, a compression of 135 PSI or better is excellent. As per the manual, minimum is 128 PSI, and a variation of 28 PSI per cylinders. Here's my readings. 170 PSI on cylinder 1, 160 PSI on cylinder 2, 155 PSI on cylinder 3, and 170 PSI on cylinder 4. My largest variation between cylinders is 15. The max allowed is 28 PSI. Now, if you had higher compression readings than normal, that could be caused by carbon buildup on the top of your pistons, and that could also cause engine pinging. Low compression would be valves or piston rings. You'll want to do a wet compression test if your readings were low. I'll cover this in another video, but all you would do is add a tablespoon of motor oil into the spark plug holes and redo the compression test. If your pressure rises, the piston rings are most likely the cause. If it doesn't, you'll have to investigate the valves causing the issue. I hope you learned something in this video. If you did, consider subscribing and hit the like button. Thanks for watching. I'll see you in the next video.